Welcome back to Mind Pump TV, guys. I'm your host, Danny Matranga, and today we're going to talk about collagen protein for building muscle. Should you do it? Should you not? We'll dive in right now. Let's do it. Every year seems to have one product that really takes off more than another. 2018 was all about MCT oils, and 2019 has been all about collagen. Now, collagen protein in particular for building muscle, that's the question today. Is it an optimal or good protein source for you to use, perhaps in a post-workout shake, maybe a pre-workout shake? Is it something you should be using often if you're looking to build muscle? So the short answer is no. And here's why. To build muscle, you do need protein, correct? However, of the protein that you get, it is particularly beneficial, or it is better if you can, to get protein high in the amino acid leucine. That's all you need to know. You want protein that has leucine. Now, the problem is, collagen does not have a lot of leucine. It has a lot of other amino acids that might be beneficial for other things. However, it is lower in leucine, which is going to limit how much potential it has to help you build muscle. So in turn, or instead of collagen, you might choose something like whey protein. If you can't do dairy, animal meat is often a very good option. If you're not into that, perhaps it's egg. And again, even if you're somebody who is vegan, there are still, in my opinion, plant-based options that might be better than collagen when it comes to selecting proteins that will better help you build muscle tissue. Now, you'll often see collagen marketed on store shelves at places like Whole Foods, and you'll see it all over supplement retailers. And it's often touted as being beneficial for joints, beneficial for skin, beneficial for hair, beneficial for the gut. And its amino acid profile, the amino acids inside it, are probably better suited for those things than they are for muscle building. Whereas something like whey protein has amino acids more aligned with building muscle than it probably does supporting hair, skin, and joints. So when you think collagen, don't think about it as a muscle building protein. Think about it as potentially having utility for other things, although a lot of the evidence is not really clear on that. So for the most part, I would recommend you stay away from it and spend your money on better protein, particularly whey, if your goal is to build muscle. I hope this helps you guys better understand some of the pros and cons of collagen supplementation, and maybe even debunks some of the hype that has surrounded it in 2019. There's plenty of good proteins out there. It doesn't mean collagen is bad, but it's definitely not the best for building muscle. Thanks so much again for tuning into Mind Pump TV. If you found this video helpful, be sure to leave it a like, subscribe to the channel, drop us a comment. We'd love to hear from you. And check out mindpumpfree.com. We've got a ton of free resources on there, from blogs to the podcast to guides, lots of awesome things to help you kind of find clarity in the fitness space. Have a good one.